With trouble in the kingdom, who could save the day? Why, of course, the three heroes of our story, Amadeus, Pontius, and Zoya. Once upon a time, they had all lived ordinary, unremarkable lives. Fates of kingdoms hadn't hung in balance because of their actions. Not until a fateful meeting had changed their lives forever. When they had discovered Trine, the artifact of soul. At that time, Pontius, a stout-hearted knight and protector of the common folk, was busy at work. He was tracking a thief who had abducted a sheep from a poor peasant family.
The no-good bandit is hiding somewhere in these ravines. I'll catch him and save that sheep, or my name isn't Pontius the Brave. I don't know what it is, but the world looks more vivid than usual this morning. See if there are any goblins in these caves. The sheep, and I'll let you go.
Oh, but this is my sheep. You must be confusing me with someone else, good sir.
I must say I'm sorry for threatening you. My mistake. Have you seen the same looking sheep as that around these parts? They'd have been stolen by a goblin who, looks an awful lot like you.
Well, you see, I stole this sheep from a completely different farm.
You thieving blackguard! He won't be getting away. We go. Sometimes you need to put your foot down. Hey! There's that blasted thief! That poor sheep is about to end up as goblin grub if I don't do something. Drop your fork and dinner knife! This sheep is going back home with me! The end of them. Let's set you free.
While Pontius was the strongest and bravest of them all, Zoya was another matter entirely. Zoya relied on her bow and her grappling hook to keep her distance from any trouble. She was brave in her way, but perhaps in a manner that was more self-serving than honorable. Zoya had been a thief long before circumstances had made her a reluctant hero. In the recent years, though, Zoya had less interested in burgling the largesse of high society. Instead, she directed her attentions abroad, far distant lands and their old forgotten ruins and treasures.
There's my prize. Come here, little jungle chicken. Finally. Why don't I take my rope out? What was that?
Last of our three heroes was Amadeus. As a young man, he dreamed of becoming a powerful sorcerer in order to impress people, but he never really got the knack for the grand fireballs he dreamt of. Amadeus was only ever good for conjuring boxes. Thankfully, it had turned out to be a skill more useful than he'd ever expected. Amadeus the Wizard was enjoying a well-deserved holiday to see migrating giant turtles with his wife Margaret and their three children. The Wizard's wife was a firebrand of a woman, and all their three children were very talented when it came to conjuring fireballs. In fact, it was a small blessing that one afternoon they had left poor Amadeus to have a nap in peace. But he slept too long. When he woke up, he was already late to see the great turtles.
I'm late. Oh, I'm so late. Let's see if they went this way. Maybe, if I climb up on the cliffs, I could have a better view of the beach. I might find the turtles as well as Margaret and the children. This skull gate is securely locked, but I want to get in. Magnificent view. And there are the turtles, on their way to make more turtles, I suppose. The artifact of soul. How nice of you to join me. Thank you again for all the magic powers you've bestowed on me, and all the marvellous adventures. If you're here about business, I'm sorry, but I'm unable to join you. You see, this is the first time I've ever been on holiday with my family since... well, since you and I first met. Please?
Oh, it's Trine. Can you wait a little? I still need to return this sheep to its family.
Oh, your timing is extremely inconvenient. Well, try.